we were doing the poem No Man Are Foreign. So now, first of all, let me ask you about the difficulties which you are facing. Yes, which paragraph? Second last paragraph. So now please listen to second last paragraph. So here it is. Let us remember when we are told to hate our brothers. It is ourselves that we shall dispossess, betray and condemn. It means that who are telling us to? It means we are not hating each other. But actually what is there? We are being told. We are told to hate our brothers and sisters. But why we are told to hate our brothers and sisters? It is because of the selfish interests, okay, selfish motives of the politicians, of the people in power, of the people who have supremacy over others, okay? So they, and in order to rule over the rest of the world, they tell people to hate their brothers. Actually, this poem is actually written when World War One ended. Okay, so it is actually the expression of the poet against colonial powers. Okay, against colonial powers means some of the, you can say when colonization took place, some of the powers, they wanted to rule over the world. And the poet is bringing about the concept of globalization. Okay, that we are not actually different from each other. We are actually brothers, and we should follow the policy of universal brotherhood. Okay, so at that time it is written. So the poet is saying that when we are told to hate our brothers and sisters, who is telling us to hate our brothers and sisters? It's not, yes, it is the people in power or politicians, those for their selfish interest, they are telling other people to hate each other. Okay, so that they can rule this world by spreading hatred. And by doing so, we shall dispossess, betray and condemn. Condemn means to disapprove. By doing so, actually we are causing harm to ourselves only, not to those people. Okay, what we are doing, we are causing harm to ourselves only. Okay, because by doing so, we are betraying ourselves. We are dispossessing ourselves, and we are condemning means we are disapproving our own identity. Right, by doing so. And remember who take arms against each other, and it is only we people who take arms against each other. And by doing so, what we are doing, we are betraying ourselves, we are causing harm to ourselves, we are defiling this earth, we are destroying this earth, and ultimately whatever destruction is caused, it is because of ourselves only, and its effects are for us only. Right? Now clear it is. Any other doubt? Second paragraph. Now, they do aware of sun, air and water. Yes, they do aware of sun, air and water means that nature is also providing their bounties. They are also utilizing the resources of nature in an equal manner. Nature is not discriminating in providing them air in a partial manner, water and sun. They are also utilizing these resources. They are also enjoying these resources of nature. Then why? Means why? What is the need of creating these boundaries? Okay, actually we have created these boundaries, but actually these boundaries are of no use to be created. They are actually causing, they are actually not meant for that. Nature is providing, nature is also endowing them with all the good qualities, but why we are doing it? Okay? So, and are fed by peaceful harvest. Fed by means same kind of situation prevails. First of all, peaceful harvest is also a metaphor used here, and it is also an example of transferred epithet. Okay, peaceful harvest, what it means. So now see peaceful harvest. Peaceful harvest and long winter start. So you just understand the meanings of these two. Please be careful. Yes. Transferred epithet, both the examples are. Right now how? Peaceful harvest means, first of all, the poet has also compared war, okay, with hell also. Okay, peaceful harvest means peaceful situation. So this is a metaphor also. Right? So now, peaceful harvest means like during peaceful times, what we have, we irrigate our fields, okay, and we get rich harvest, okay, because of peaceful situation, there is no problem of food, there is no scarcity of food, there is not any, you can say the food is not scanty, okay, we get enough food. So it means that during peaceful times, all countries, they face similar type of situation, that is they enjoy peace, okay, peaceful, okay, they enjoy peace. But during winter, winter is also compared to that of war, okay. But during war, what type of time prevails? That is that of winter, where there is, you can say, fear of shortage of food, okay. Because during winter, no plants bloom, no flowers they yield, okay. No fruits are born on mostly on the trees. So during that time, there are mainly famine, okay. People don't get, you can say, supply of food grains, okay, there is shortage, their lives are suffering. So this is the reason why he said long winter start. It means that during peace and during war, what kind of situation prevails, it is being explained by this line right now, okay. So next, afterwards, the next line is, their hands are ours, and in their lines we read a labor not different from our own, okay. Their hand are ours, means we have the same physiognomy, okay? Okay, similar type of hands. If we have five fingers, same they have, there is not much difference between us and them. Then what is the need of creating those differences? We are all together same, we are not different from each other, and in their lines we reach a labor not different from our own. If we are putting in hard labor, okay, and ultimately, the same they are getting, right? If we are putting in hard labor, after doing hard labor, we are getting the result in a fruitful manner, then how they are different? They are not at all different. They are altogether same. If our hard work results into, you can say, peaceful results, it results into, you can say, admirable results, then why not they? They are also facing the same situation. They are also getting the result of their hard work. It means that same kind of values and, you can say, moral lines, our life works upon like them. Then what is the difference? There is no difference at all. Actually, through this paragraph, the poet wants to explain that there is not much difference between them and the people of our own country. We are creating territories, we are creating boundaries, but actually there is not much difference between those people and us. Right? Okay, now, clear? Any other doubt in the poem? Okay, let us see for the poetic devices. So in the poetic devices, first of all, there is no rhyme scheme for the poem, okay? It's written in a free verse. So here is earth like this, okay? Second paragraph, long winter, starved, led by hearts in their own, different not from others. So first of all, their hands are ours and in their lines we read. Okay, so see this line. There is consecutive use of conjunction and. See in one line how many times it is used. It is used, their hands are ours and in their lives. It means after every two words consecutively and is used. Okay, means when the conjunctions are used repeatedly. Write down. When conjunctions are used repeatedly, right, when conjunctions are used repeatedly, this poetic device, it is called as polysyndeton. Okay, it is called as polysyndeton. Okay, when conjunctions are used consecutively in a line, what it is called as? It is called as polysyndeton. Like in another line it is used here, okay? For example, in the first line, they too aware of sun and air and water. And air and end water again and again and is used. Okay, so when conjunctions are used repeatedly in a sentence, this is called as polysyndeton. Okay. So alliteration is an example, like for example, second paragraph, wars, winter, okay, repetition of consonant sounds, right? So there is also transferred epithet, I have told you, peaceful harvest and winter storm. These are the examples of transferred epithet, okay? And moreover, metaphor. Metaphor is also used. How metaphor is used? When war is compared to that of health. Here in the last paragraph, it is written a hells of fire. Here hell is what it represents? It represents war. Okay, and winter here, winter star. Winter is also representing war. Winter is also representing war, which leads to starvation. Okay, so this is also an example of metaphor. Okay, so what is this? This is also an example of metaphor. Okay, so what this poem, it tells us, this poem explains or it delivers the message of universal brotherhood, that we should not be different from each other. Okay, we should not try to separate ourselves from the rest of the races of the world. Actually, the poet is developing, is forwarding the idea of globalization, that we all are one. Actually, we have created the territories and boundaries, but this is a wrong notion. Here now, understood now? Yes, Ashmit.
Ma'am, what is that poetic device, ma'am? You were telling, ma'am, when conjunctions are used repeatedly.
Polysyndeton.
Ma'am, could you please spell that?
I'm spelling it here. It is written. Silence, please. Polysyndeton, when conjunctions are used consecutively in a sentence or successively in a sentence. For example, land. In the second paragraph, first line, aware of sun and air and water. Okay? Their hands are ours and in their lines. No, this is not the example. So first line is the example of polysyndeton, right? So now, clear now? Poem is clear, so now let us discuss the question answers of the poem also. So let us see the question answers. Beneath all uniforms, what uniforms do you think the poet is speaking about? What you are saying? Military. Okay. I'm not able to interpret the word right. Okay, so it means that military or the uniforms of the soldiers. Okay, so when the poet is talking about beneath all uniforms, what it means that uniforms, they have the purpose of separating the armies of the different countries. They want to separate their soldiers or people from the other. But actually, beneath all uniforms, the same body, there is uniformity in the life processes. Same processes of life, same heartbeat, same blood circulation is there, same systems. They are continuing in everybody. So there is no use of making any difference. Okay, like that. And uniforms here, they are playing the role which is ironical in nature. Right? That's clear?
Yes.
So next one, next question is, how does the poet suggest that all people on earth are same? So how he is suggesting that all people are same?
All people on earth are the same.
So let us see in the the sequence from the point that what the poet says, that how there is similarity. So in the first paragraph, all uniform single body piece means there is no use of demarcating ourselves from different from the people of other countries, as we all are same. Okay, these uniforms, they are not serving the purpose of separating ourselves from others, right? Okay. And like us, land brothers walk upon the same type of land on which we walk upon, we work and we live, and their land is also altogether similar like that of ours. Okay, and is earth like this? Is earth like this? Is similar. Okay, and in here it is peaceful harvest and winter stop. Are also the examples of similarity. The same type of effects are faced by the people when they are living a peaceful life and when they are living a life of life during the war. They also face the same kind of death and destruction as well as scarcity of food. Same boundaries of nature. Same boundaries of nature are also shared by them, like that of air, water, and sun. They also have the same physiognomy. They have the same type of hands, same type of body like ours. That they and they also walk on the same land, right? Yes. Same efforts and labor is put in by all the people, and they get the result of it. And similarly is happening with us, right? Then he has also explained about the same eyes like ours. Okay, again, similarly, same eyes like ours. Okay, so they also have the same type of eyes, same type of body structure like ours, and they also follow the same pattern of awakening as well as sleeping. So there is yes, and there is, and their strength is only won by love, like our strength can be won by love. So there are number of similarities shown. Okay, the poet throughout the poem is actually justifying the fact that we are not different from each other. It is only we who have created the boundaries, but actually there is not any use of creating these kind of boundaries. Yes, similarities are there. So the next question is, in stanza one, find the ways in which we all are alike without the words.
No man are strange.
No men are strange. How we are same. Yes, that although the soldiers or the people or the militaries of the different countries, they are separated by wearing different kind of uniforms, but actually under those uniforms there is single type of body, that there is similarity in the body. Same life processes are going on under the uniforms, and how we are different from each other. Okay, and there is same type of land in which we live, and we also are a part of the same planet. Okay, which they share. Okay, and there is not much difference. Yes, after death we all shall lie in the same land. So how can we be different? Although there are different processes, okay, or the different rituals they have followed for different religions, but ultimately the end is same. Finally. So we are not at all different. So next is, how many common features can you find in stanza 2? This I have already discussed with you. Okay, so yes, right. So next is, yes, we all enjoy, right? Fine. Okay. So next is fourth question. Whenever we are told to hate our brothers, when do you think this happens? Why? Who tells us? And should we do as we are told at such times? What does the poet say? Yes. Who are told? The past people who are in supremacy, people who are in power, they are told. Okay, why? For their selfish interests, for their personal benefits, for their selfish interest. Okay, they are telling to hate our peoples in order to rise in power, in order to dictate the other people. They are telling so. Yes, divide and rule, right? But actually, what is there? There is not much difference between the people of our country and that of other countries.
We should not act as a puppet in their hands.
Very good. We should not be act as puppet in their hands. So write down one more question. What is same in every land, and whom should this be remembered by? What is same in every land, and who should this be remembered by? Right? So this is the question that you have to write down, because very few questions are there. Okay? And I will also provide you extracts to write. And by whom this be remembered by? Yes. Whom this be remembered by? Yes. So what is same in every land? What is same in every land? Air, water and land is same in every part of the world, in every piece of land. The same type of life is affected, or the life is affected in the same manner during war as well as during peaceful times. As in peaceful times, there is not any shortage of food, crops, and moreover, people enjoy their lives. Okay, they leave, they have a peaceful sleep also. But during war times, what is there? There is dearth of everything, there is fear of everything, there is starvation of everything, right? Yeah? They face similar kind of situation. Okay? And by whom they should be remembered by? They should be remembered by all the inhabitants of this world. By all the citizens of this world, that actually we are not different from each other. We are, of course, same. Okay, that we are same. Next question. What do we actually do to our Mother Earth? What do we actually do to our Mother Earth? We create territories and boundaries. Yes, by fighting with each other, by use of, you can say, arms and ammunition as well as nuclear weapons, there is creation of, or there are created hells of fire. Hells of fire means it's a metaphor used, okay, means that the effects are far off, destructive in nature. They are causing too much of destruction. Okay, and by usage of all this, we are causing a lot of destruction to this earth. And ultimately, what we are causing defile. Okay, we defile our earth. It means that destruction is caused to our earth only. Here now, that's fine. Okay. So, what can be won by love? The strength can be won by love. Okay, the strength of the people of the other countries, it can be won by love. Okay. So, if you have your fair notebooks, open it out. So write down next track. We have 5 minutes with us. Right? So let us write down extract. So the first extract is, remember no man are strange till we all shall lie. Okay, write down the questions for it. First question is, what message does the poet want to convey through this passage? Universal Brotherhood is trying to convey the message to shun all the differences, to leave aside all the differences, to rise above the prejudices, and ultimately follow the policy of Universal Brotherhood. Okay? How uniforms are ironical in nature. Yes, ultimately that we are trying to demarcate ourselves from the rest of the people, but actually under all uniform, the same body breathes, means which is altogether same in the life processes that are undergoing, and ultimately we are not different from others. Okay? What are the difference? Ways expressed by the poet show similarity. Among people of the world. We all walk on the same land. We all have the same color. Right. Okay, so all these examples you will write down. First extract one only. Right, so tomorrow, what you have your pair notebook side by side so that you can write down the questions in the class and answer them. Right? Okay? So that's all for today. And moreover, one story writing I have already given you. You remember? So raise up your hands. How many of you have noted it down? Good. Very good. And rest of the students, come with your stories. So very good. Okay, so that I can have an idea, okay, from you all that what you have written. And this story was given when an outline was given. Next story I will give you, like when some cues are given. Okay, so then you will develop that story. Okay, right?